AIDS, HIV, and sucking thing in the parking lot, huh?
You didn't show up today with HIV, AIDS, any of them deadly sexual transmitted diseases that make you die 2-3 weeks, put a cell phone like that up. Lady, if your smell like water, put a cell phone like that up. Fellas.
Lights up.
Fellas, if you ain't sucking in the parking lot, put your cell phone like that.
Let's be real about this.
Yeah, keep it real.
Some of y'all suspect as a motherfucker. Let's be real.
And peep game, I already know DaBaby and T.I. don't give a damn about nothing I'm about to say, but this video is made for people that want to understand and learn why what they said was not only wrong, but damn sure unethical as well. Number one, when you correlate disease, AIDS, HIV to homosexuality, you're literally trying to conjure up fear about this particular community, which is textbook homophobia. It's unethical, which brings me to number two. When you conflate HIV and AIDS together, because they're two separate things, as being something that make you drop dead in 2 to 3 weeks, this pushes misinformation, which is also wrong. Speaking of being wrong, number three, it comes off as being very disingenuous when you talking about diseases that make you drop dead in 2 to 3 weeks, and you in a super spreader event rolling loud where we got the Delta variant and we got the quadrant variant rolling around. That seemed unethical as well. Number five, not only was DaBaby's comments homophobic, they were also homo-negative. When he started talking about dudes giving fellatios in the parking lot, that correlated deviancy and negativity to homosexual acts and homosexuality. Number six, because somehow T.I. threw in his two cents. He said, if Lil Nas X can kick his shit in peace, so should DaBaby. Equality. What? See, what I would let Mr. Tip know is that in my profession, we call that a false correlation. You cannot equate gay people coming out as being peaceful and people talking shit about gay people as being peaceful. Ain't the same thing. Number seven, Tip also thought he was being clever when he said some shit like, video. And if you're gonna have a Lil Nas X video and him living his truth, you're gonna damn sure have people like DaBaby who gonna speak their truth. And it ain't nothing wrong with none of it. It ain't got to be no hate. It's our honesty. It is hateful to correlate deviancy or disease with homosexual people. Number eight, it don't come off as disingenuous to y'all hearing Tip talking about kids being influenced by seeing WAP and Lil Nas X videos. If his kids ain't influenced about hearing what him and his wife doing, you know, I'm somebody that grew up looking up to Tip. You feel me? Shit, I remember the Tip Drill video was Nelly, you know what I'm saying? But you remember talking about, hey, let's get away on the other side of town and having threesomes and stuff? 10, man, let's get into this contradiction right here. On one end, y'all make music that celebrates slutting women now, and then y'all turn around and slut shame. Which brings me to number 11. Y'all shit is textbook heteronormativity, where y'all normalize sexuality amongst heterosexuals. Because peep game, if it was dudes getting head in the parking lot by women, wouldn't there be no issue with that, would it? My final point, man, if some of us ain't free, then none of us is free. And it's a lot of people inside of our community that do oppressive, hurtful shit to people inside of our community. And what Tip and Baby